Jim, I understand Indium Corporation has a really fascinating history. I also understand you have a book that chronicles it.
I do. I have a copy here of the second edition of Indium by Maria Ludwig, and this copy is for you.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. I appreciate it.
It's a pretty hefty book. I understand from what you told me that the book basically details the work of William Murray.
Yeah.
And what can you tell us about him?
William S. Murray is actually a very interesting gentleman who took this material, which had been discovered earlier, decades earlier, and needed to use it, wanted to use it, but there was nothing commercially available. And so he set out to find a way to refine indium so it could be useful to us. So he did the work to find how do we mine it, refine it, how do we get a tangible amount of this, and then he helped find the first applications for it.
And of course, William Murray became the founder of Indium Corporation.
Yeah.
Very good. Who wrote this book?
This was written by Maria Ludwig, who worked with William Murray, and she compiled this book because there were 20 years of scattered information here and there, and she wanted to put this all into one place. So that's what became of this book. This book starts out with an introduction, like a biography of Indium Corporation and William S. Murray, and then after that there's phase diagrams, there's properties of indium, and a lot of different information about the first applications and the first different studies.
So what were some of the properties that captured William S. Murray's imagination, and what were some of the early applications that arose from that?
Right, well, this book was written around World War II, and in that time, one of the early applications was to dope bearings for aircraft with indium, and it formed a self-lubrication for the bearings, and it made the engines last much, much longer. So that was one of the first applications. You can find information in this book of different test soldering to different materials. Common materials like copper, some difficult materials like steel, and then also people were just trying to find out, would it solder to a brick or a seashell or something like that?
I don't know. Last time I was trying to solder a seashell to a brick. Yeah, anyway, but you, what can you say? You never know, they're out there. By the way, what are they able to?
Well, you'll have to read the book.
Ah, there we go. Well, good. Well, for more information, besides obtaining a copy of this book, and this one's mine, where can people go to learn more information about the history of Indium Corporation, William S. Murray, and some of the other aspects of the properties and applications?
You can always send me an email or give me a call. My email address is jheiser@indium.com. And indium.com is a website that's filled with information about indium, and our engineers love to talk about it and would love to talk to our customers about it.
Very good.
Yeah.
Jim, thank you so much.
Thank you, Phil.